ISUPK.
Hey, salam, man. It's Priest Kevin Gadonhall with the ISUPK. And the Commander Journey and Honor in California, man. To all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Subscribe to this channel, man. You want true salvation? You're going to learn from the priests and prophets of the ISUPK, man. Subscribe to that channel. Hit that button, man. And to stand with that, salam.
All I ever wanted was to be a gangster. Little did I know I was in danger. Decisions that I made provoked the Lord's anger. Prayed to him all the time, but I was just a stranger. All I ever wanted was to be a gangster. Little did I know I was in danger. Decisions that I made provoked the Lord's anger. Prayed to him all the time, but I was just a stranger. All I wanted was to be a gangster. And shot call to be known with them niggas letting shots off. Either that or the right hand to the top dog. Funny how we see vanity, not the lives lost. Can't be focused on a life that's hopeless. Out there pumping, not knowing the Lord will kill you for that hocus pocus. Used to roll with niggas that cook dope with weaponry. Same ones claim they love you, I had your life in jeopardy. And I know my mother wants success for me. But that G should take a girl straight to extras.
Let me get 1 Corinthians 14 and 33. You understand what I'm saying? You want to say something? 14 and 33.
You're lying. There is color when you're talking about Jesus Christ. You are a liar. Give me Revelations 1 and 1. Real quick. Turn up this mic right here real quick. Huh? Give me Revelations 1 and 1. How the hell you going to come out here and say there ain't no color when you're talking about Jesus? What book you can prove that out of? You just run in your mouth. Why? If we're going to talk the truth. In fact, first, give me 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21. Stick your finger right there on Revelations. Give me 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21. I ain't got no problem with anybody disagreeing. But if you're going to disagree, prove what you're saying. Don't just run your mouth based on what you feel. Bring a book. Bring some history. Bring some sort of facts. Or else, you just talking under your own accord, under your own understanding. Help him out here in the car, real quick. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21. Barack, you got it? Give me 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21. I don't got no problem if you disagree with me. I ain't never said that I got the truth. But the knowledge that comes out of this school, the Israelite school at UPK, it's the truth. And I'm not telling you what I think. I'm telling you what has been proven. Give me 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21.
Karuakala. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 21. Prove all things.
Say it again.
Prove all things.
What does the Bible say?
Prove all things.
Say it, tell them where you're at.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 21.
That's in the New Testament for all you ultimate super Christians.
That's right.
For all you super Saiyan Christians. It's in the New Testament, 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21.
Prove all things.
If you're going to say something, do what?
Prove all things.
Say what? Do what?
Prove all things.
Well, prove all things. If there's no color when we're talking about Jesus Christ, prove it. Prove it. Show it to me. Show it to me that historically, Jesus Christ didn't have no color. Wasn't he a man like anybody else? Don't men have color? Don't men got race? Don't you got white men, Chinese, African, East Indian? You got Filipinos, Vietnamese? So you mean to tell me you know a man that ain't got no color? Huh? Who's that, Captain Planet? That's who we dealing with right now? You don't know what you're talking about. You don't know what you're talking about. And really, what you all don't understand? She ain't got a problem with the color of Christ. And listen, the brother was talking about drug dealing and living a filthy lifestyle, and she lost her mind. Because really, she got a problem with us talking about her problem is drug dealing and that filthy homosexual lifestyle. Her problem ain't the color of Christ. She was quiet until the brother was talking about stop selling your own people drugs. And listen, man, I ain't knocking no brother who before today or sister who was selling drugs. I ain't knocking you if you was getting high on drugs. I understand the lifestyle of America pushes us to do certain things. But from today on, if after this message you continue with that life, then the judgment is on you. Then your blood is on you. Because you taking up the damn sword for the damn white man. The American government put drugs in our neighborhoods. And now they turn and give us the license to kill each other for it. And call us drug dealers and criminals. When ain't nobody called Ronald Reagan and his woman a drug dealer. Ain't nobody called Oliver North and Poindexter drug dealers. But you want to come up here and try to shut this down just because we talking about drug dealing. You can't shut this down. This is the Lord's damn program. You got a problem with this? Take it up with God. Now let's get back to what she said, what she wrongly said. And I don't know if she purposely ignorant, but you are grossly misinformed. How in the hell you gonna say there ain't no color when talking about Christ? Let's see what the Bible says. Step back. Go ahead.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1.
Go ahead.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
Say it again.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
One more time.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
Now listen, man, that's my sister at the end of the day. She a black woman, just like the rest of my black sisters. We may disagree. We may disagree, but that's my people. Now let me ask you something. Now listen, I'm gonna put you up on game. What does the word revelation mean?
All revelation means.
Uh-huh.
It's right here. The war between Satan.
Mm-mm.
Now listen, the war between Satan and God is coming to an end, which is us.
That's not what the word revelation means. That's not what the word revelation means. Okay. Sis, you gotta be willing to listen. Sis, you got to be willing to listen. You gonna listen or no? You see what I'm saying? We too proud. That's why we can't really come together fully as a people. You interrupted me. I listened to what he was saying, and I decided to address it. Now I asked you a question. Hold on, sis, I'm speaking. Hold on, sis, we're going to deal with this civilly. We're going to deal with this like brothers and sisters. I let you speak. I heard what you said, that revelation is a war between God and Satan. That's what you said. Now I'm telling you that's wrong, and according to the Bible, and I'm about to prove it to you. Pull up Revelation on your phone.
Don't yell, read it.
Hold on. The Bible says, cry aloud and spare not.
Right.
I can't talk how you want to talk. I had to talk how God said to talk. You was yelling over there quite a second ago. I ain't tell you stop yelling. You was yelling, sis. You was over there. I was hearing you over everybody else. So don't tell me don't yell now. Come on. All right? All right? Cool. Hold on, brother. I'm talking to her. Ain't no sweat. You ain't got to do all that. You got it? Go up. Look up dictionary. Hold on. I got you right here. Listen, we got these smartphones. You gotta download Webster's. Hold on. No. Chill out.
That's the problem.
Chill out, sis. This is a dictionary. This is a dictionary. You see, you ain't want no knowledge. That's the problem. You don't want no knowledge. You ain't want no knowledge. Revelation is a regular word. Hold on, right one minute. I'll a second too late. Read this right here.
I can bring you some good to show
a
you.
A usually secret or surprise fact that is made known.
Say it again. What does revelation mean?
A usually secret or surprise fact that is made known.
Say it one more time.
A usually secret or surprising fact. That is made known.
The word revelation, according to Webster's Merriam Dictionary, is a usually secret fact that is surprising, that is made known. Now the sister just said, and she ain't want no knowledge. And I ain't mad at her. She ain't want no knowledge. But I'ma teach the rest of my people. I'm proving it. No, it ain't no opinion. I'ma prove it. If I'm wrong, you gotta prove me wrong. If I'm wrong, you gotta prove me wrong. Don't tell me this ain't no truth. Bring another truth to stand on what I'm saying. Read again.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revelation of who?
Jesus Christ.
The revelation of who?
Jesus Christ.
Well, the book of Revelation said this is the revealing. A secret about Jesus Christ that is not known. A surprise fact that is otherwise not known. Now skip me down to verse 13.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 13. And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one light unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot.
Standing in the middle of the seven candlesticks, In the Bible, the seven candlesticks, each one represents the schools or the churches that the Apostle Paul set up in Asia Minor. And he set up seven of those major schools. And in the vision of John the Revelator, he is seeing one like unto the Son of Man. Who is the Son of Man? Jesus Christ. Standing in the middle of those candlesticks. And he had a garment long to the foot. Long garment down. Go ahead.
And girt about the pack with the golden girdle.
And he had a war belt made of solid gold around his pack, around his midsection. Why? Because at that time, the swords and knives, he got something to keep his butt in and protect himself. Keep going.
14. His head and his hair.
His what?
His head and his hair.
Where's the sister that said there ain't no color when you're talking about Jesus Christ? His what?
His head and his hair.
This is giving you a physical description of him. Don't when we commit a crime, they tell us, they go on TV and say the police are in search of a tall black man with this type of hair and that type of hair. Well, they're telling you a description of Jesus Christ right now. His what?
His head and his hair.
His head and his hair, the hair on his head and the hair on his face. Go ahead.
It were white like wool.
Was what?
Was white like wool.
Was what?
Were white like wool.
They were white like wool. White is a color, wool is a texture. Who got woolly hair on the earth? Where's the sister? Huh? She gone? Anybody else agree with her? Who got woolly hair on the earth? Huh? I could show you woolly hair right now. Look at that brother right here. The young brother right here. He got that good wool and it glowing. All on his face. Let's imagine that. But it was white, gray hair. White woolly hair. Ain't no white man got woolly hair. Ain't no Chinese got woolly hair. Ain't no East Indian got no woolly hair. The Africans, they say they got woolly hair, but that don't grow. I ain't never seen no African with no long hair. Wale been growing them dreads since he was a little boy. A black man started growing dreads in 2 months, it's long to his back. We the ones with woolly hair. Keep reading.
As white as snow.
Go ahead.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
And his eyes was as a flame of fire. He had a serious look and his eyes was red. Why? Because Christ drank some wine. He wasn't no drunkard, but he do enjoy a good drink. Just like who? Just like brothers. A black man, as soon as you finish your slave, as soon as you finish your job, you go to that corner store and you get you a fifth of wine, a fifth of Jack. You like it, you enjoy a good drink. And so does your King, Jesus Christ. And he got a serious, fierce look. Just like every black man. That's why they approach us with so much fear. Think we angry, when that's just our face, man. We got a serious look, but we masculine men. Go ahead.
Verse 15. And his feet like unto fire.
And his what?
And his feet.
His what?
His feet.
Spell it.
F-E-E-T.
Notice it said his feet, not his boots, not his shoes, not his sandals or his slippers. His feet, his flesh. Go ahead.
Like unto fine brass.
Was what?
Like unto fine brass.
And his feet was what?
It was like unto fine brass.
Now I got a question for you. Or that sister, she's still around. Talking about there ain't no color when talking about Christ. What color is brass? Anybody know? What color is brass? No, you put your hand up. What color is brass? Huh? What color is brass? It's brown. It's brown. So how could she say there ain't no color when talking about Jesus Christ? When the Bible says he was brown. And not just brown. Go ahead.
As if they burned in a furnace.
As if it burned in a furnace. Meaning he was a beautiful brown. A beautiful brown. Flawless brown. You see him walking. It's like, damn, brother. God damn, brother. He was a black man. Don't let nobody fool you and tell you that Jesus Christ ain't got no color. Don't let nobody fool you and tell you that Jesus Christ was a white boy. They take all the great people of our nation and try to make them somebody else. In 50 years, if Christ ain't back, Michael Jordan gonna be white, Michael Jackson, and he already white. All our famous people, they're gonna portray them as white people. Y'all seen that Madame Tussauds, That building, that wax museum she got, they did a damn statue of Beyonce and it looked just like some, like that white girl. What's her name? Not Christina Aguilera. She's the other one, the crackhead. Britney Spears. It looked just like Britney Spears and they said this is Beyonce. because they are going to whitewash every one of our great people, just like they whitewashed the greatest man on the face of the earth, Jesus Christ. And he was a black man, and he was from the tribe of Judah. And black man, you from the tribe of Judah. You're the real Jew. And they gave us this filthy image to worship, and now we walking around looking at each other like we ain't shit, like we ain't nothing. When a black man is the real Jew of the earth, we're the special people of the earth. So how dare she come and say, there ain't no color when it comes to Jesus Christ. If color doesn't matter, then nothing matters. Tell me what else does not matter about somebody if color don't matter. You going for a job, why they ask you what race you are if color don't matter? When somebody commits a crime and they call the cops, if color don't matter, why don't you, when they say, and what race was he? Well, that doesn't matter. Why don't you say that to the cops? Don't fall for that Christian game up, man. Color does matter. It mattered with Eric Garner. It mattered with Oscar Brego. It mattered with Sandra Bland. It mattered with Emmett Till. It mattered with Botham Jean. Color mattered with Amber Geiger. You saw that damn judge went down there and hugged her. You saw that damn the brother went down there and hugged her and cried like if she was the victim. When Botham Jean sitting stiff and cold in a goddamn grave. Color does matter. It mattered with Tatiana Jefferson. She in her damn house, the door open, some nosy neighbor done called the damn hit squad. Cop run up in there and shoot her through a damn window in her own goddamn house. Color does matter. It does matter. It will always matter. It always has mattered, and it always will matter. And with that, the white man is the devil, the Bible speaks of. Take that for your color. Come on back up.
And then y'all give a strong hand for that priest and prophet of the Lord, man. He was bringing out some heavy points, man. Y'all give a strong hand for him, man, because that's what we up here to do. We up here to teach the truth to our brothers and sisters, man. That sister or anybody else that thinks that color is not in the Bible, man, do you understand? We would rather accept sin. We would rather accept not knowing our identity than being told the truth. Do you understand? Because the truth means, well, my entire life I've been living a lie. Now I got to live a truth. I don't want to accept it. I don't want to change. You understand? Color is in the Bible. Our culture is in the Bible. The way that we're supposed to move and walk and talk to our brothers and sisters is in the Bible. Everything about a black, native, and Hispanic, a man and man, woman and child, is in the Bible. Do you understand what I'm saying? These are our records, and we got to cherish these records because don't nobody else on the face of this earth cherish these records, man. We got to cherish these records, man. Give me Galatians chapter 6.
Let me say one more thing there. Stay right there, brother. And let me tell you something, that sister, she don't give a damn about color. You notice when the proof came out, she and that brother left? You know why? If you always hear early enough, this brother was bringing out the effects of living a sinful lifestyle in America. And he was particularly talking about being a drug dealer and a drug addict and being a homosexual. And then she started talking. And as soon as he stopped talking about drugs and color, she left. Because she's struggling with one of the two things or both, what he's talking about. Let me tell you something, man. We ain't no different. Thank you, brother. Go ahead, put it in, man. Put it in. Ain't no sweat. Get a flyer too. Talk to this brother at the table. He gonna set you up. Let me tell you something, man. Where you think we come from? You think we fell out the sky? We come from the same streets and hard life like you.
That's right.
We suffered from the same addictions you suffered from. And we came in here and got strong, man. The difference between addiction and being a righteous man is strength. And making a decision to be strong. You ain't gonna start off strong. You go in the gym the first day, you gonna bench press 300 pounds? Hell no. You gonna start off low and work your way up. That takes strength to go in there and suffer pain every day till you get strong. Weakness is saying, I can't do 300, so I ain't going at all. If you got a problem and you out there, you come to this school and we gonna fix you.
That's right.
I'm putting that on everything. I'm putting that on everything. You come in here, you are going to get fixed. There ain't no problem, no issue that you have that's stronger than God's words. You understand? You come in here and get fixed. Don't come and sidetrack something because we hitting on what you doing to destroy yourself and destroy other people. The brother talked about child molestation too. Who in the hell gonna have a problem when we talking about not molesting your children? And she got a nerve to interrupt this. Something is going on in her household that she doesn't want talked about. And that's why she interrupted the brother. Because now if color was so important to her, she'd have stayed and heard the truth. But she ran. You got a problem out there, you come and get fixed, man.
We're
going to fix you. Not like the white man and fully up with all kind of drugs. We're going to show you how to be strong. We're going to show you how to fight. Life is about war. Life is war. When you get up in the morning, you don't want to wake up out of your bed, but you go to war with yourself to get up. You say, come on, get up. Time to go. You got to wake them children up. They crying, pulling the sheets back. You got to go to war with that child. Life is about war. Everything is war. You in traffic is war to get a space. You got to go to war with yourself, man. We could teach you how to do it. Because somebody taught me how to do it. His name is Commander Jerome Yohana. And he learned from our King Jesus Christ. Follows him to a T, man. God is a man of war. Learn to go to war and stop being a goddamn weak Christian your whole life, man. Right. Go ahead, man.
Trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, so packed, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road, like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, but it's guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how did you excel? Wisdom the breath of life, I believe in fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With